Hi, my name is Rahul Bhatia. I'm an engineer by profession. I have a question. In Quran verse 22, ayat 47, it says, "Verily a day in the sight of the Lord is like 1,000 years of your reckoning." Also in Quran 32, ayat number 5, it says, "To him on a day the space whereof will be 1,000 years of your reckoning." And in Quran 70, ayat number 4, it says, "The angels and the spirit ascend unto him in a day, the measure whereof is 50,000 years. So which one, the measure of a day is 1,000 years or 50,000 years in the sight of Allah?
But the Rahul is your name, correct?
Yeah.
I think the same person who asked yesterday about the 6 days and the 8 days.
Yes.
MashaAllah, I love you, brother.
Thank you. I love you too.
These, as I told you, on the internet, all these are common questions. You don't have to be a scholar to know all these things. Go on the internet, on the anti-Islamic site, and you'll get hundreds. I'm sure, Brother Rahul, have you read the full Quran, Brother Rahul?
No. Not fully.
Correct. I know that.
I'm afraid that I'm going to get more questions, so I want to sort these out
the
first.
The thing is that, see, if you want to know the truth, first you have to read the direct source. If I want to know Christianity, and if I read the anti-Christian books, then I'll become biased. So my request to you, Brother Rahul, is first go to the good side. Read the Quran, then don't ask me 2 questions, ask me 200.
Yeah.
Inshallah, I'll reply. I'll reply.
Okay.
But I, being in the field of Dawah, I realize that people go to the anti-Islamic sites first, and they see a negative point, they get convinced, and they're against Islam. If you want to know Islam, go to the good side. Don't go to sites like Answering Islam.
The point is, I can actually speak for half an hour in favor of Islam as well. I'm totally unbiased.
I'll give the reply. This is all common for me. It's nothing new.
Yeah.
This has been asked to me several times before. I can give references, everything, mashallah. The brother has a question that 2 places in the Quran where Allah says that one day in the sight of Allah is equal to 1,000 years. And 1 place in Surah Ma'arij, chapter number 70, verse number 4, that one day in the sight of Allah is equal to 50,000 years. So isn't there contradiction? Like one place it says 1,000 years, other places it says that 50,000 years. In Arabic, the word used is yom. The word used is?
Yom.
Yom. Now, yom has got 2 meanings. One of the meanings is day. Day. Like a 24-hour day. The other meaning is a period. Epoch can be any number of years or whatever it is. So one meaning of yom is day, the other meaning is a period. So now if you read it correctly, that one verse says that for the up years to go up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will take 1,000 years of your reckoning. It's like one day, one period, which is equal to 1,000 years of your reckoning. The other verse says in Surah Ma'arij, chapter 70, verse number 4, that for the angels to ascend unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will take a period of one period, which is equal to 50,000 years. For example, if I tell you that for me to travel from Dubai to Abu Dhabi takes 1 hour, and for me to travel from Dubai to, say, USA in a very slow plane will take me 50 hours. The period taken for me to travel from Dubai to Abu Dhabi is 1 hour. The period taken for me to travel from Dubai to New York is 50 hours. It is not a contradiction, because both the things are different. So here again, when Allah says about the up years to travel, it's a different time period. And for the angels to go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's a different time period. It's not a contradiction. There are 2 different things. Therefore, the time periods are different. So if you translate day as 24 hours, then there's a contradiction. If you translate day as a period, like Allah says, He has created the universe in 6 days, in 6 ayams. It cannot be 6 24-hour days. Then there's a contradiction. It is 6 periods, 6 epochs, which scientists don't have any objection to. So here too, yom is a period. And all these answers, you can go to my website, irf.net, www.irf.net. And inshallah, most of these answers are there. Hope that answers the question.
Okay. So basically, it refers to 2 different things.
That's right.
Excellent. Okay. And the word where it's the using there are two different words. Yeah, one is day in Arabic, and the other
yom
one
has got two meanings. Okay. One meaning is 21st day. There is an epoch or a period.
And is this the word yom has been used in both the
same 100% same.
Same word has been used to refer to a day.
All the three verses which you have quoted, Surah Hajj also, Surah Ma'arij also, including when Allah says they have created the earth and the heaven in 6 days, the same yom is used. But the plural is ayam. Same in Surah Fusilat, chapter number 41. You might have forgotten the reference, verse number 9 to 12, the same ayam is used.
Right, so and that word can mean a day and or it can mean a period.
But here it only means a period, an epoch.
Right, and a period can be
any period can be 1 hour, can be 10 hours, can be 10 years, 1,000 years, 1,000,000 years, 1,000,000,000 years.
And the two things are actually referring to two different things, so
that's
it
right.
Can be excellent.
Hope
thank you.
Hope you are convinced.
I am. I'm going at the back for my next turn. Thank you.